Aaron 95, what's up, bro? Kim Tortilla asks, Heinz, it's CC. Yes, it is. It's the overnutrition George Clooney. So you read the title of the live, Kyle Rittenhouse is a real American hero. And I say that just to piss people off. Right now, the liberal media is absolutely losing their shit. Augustus. They're losing their shit. They're losing their shit on fucking Twitter. They're losing their shit on you know, media outlets. It is unfucking believable. Let's see here. Maurice, 1990. If it you, the new father. The total package. Can you call father on live right now? I think that would be kind of disrespectful, just calling him dry, telling him that I'm live right now, and I think I would have to give him some type of notice. Augustus, hope I'm not late, just got the notification. No, you're not late. Fuck Dog is here. Kim Tortilla asks, Heinz, star witness admits Kyle only shot when gun was pulled on him. The fucking prosecution and the left and these liberal motherfuckers, they thought for sure that they were going to get a conviction on this kid because he's white. Right now, you can go on Twitter. The most common thing these assholes are saying is, he had no business being there. He had no business being there. Like, for some reason, because he had no business being there is all the reason why he's guilty. So he has no business being there, so therefore he's guilty. No, I'm actually drinking. If you haven't seen it yet, Budweiser has released these limited time cans. And the cans have a symbol on them that looks like the SS Nazi symbol. So right now I'm drinking Nazi Budweiser beer. But here's the thing, all these assholes crying out, Kyle Rittenhouse had no business being there. The last time I checked, he went to Kenosha because he was helping out a friend of the family. He was helping defend that property. And, yeah, so this idea, this thing that he had no business being there, whether he had business being there or not, what the fuck does that mean? Does that mean that he's guilty just because he had no business being there? He was fucking under attack, you cunt. But they're losing their fucking shit right now. And I'm loving every fucking second of it. Loving it. Peep it. Don't tread on me. Kim Tortilla asks Heinz, yes, the owner said he didn't ask Kyle to protect his business. That's true. But at the end of the day, whether he had no business being there or not, they had no business fucking attacking him. Let me tell you something. If it wasn't going to be Kyle Rittenhouse, it would have been someone else. I'm telling you right now. If it wasn't going to be that kid, it was going to end up being someone else. Ugh. Oh, shit. So what else? We have businesses that are so fucking tyrannical. I listen to a lot of talk radio as much as I can. But I heard a call today that it sounds like something a piece of shit fucking company would do. So from what I understand, everything is still frozen because I don't think the Department of Justice reacted yesterday towards the freeze from the Federal Court of Appeals as far as the current administration overreaching, as far as OSHA overreaching with these fucking mandates. So apparently there's a couple of companies out there that they know that the deadline was supposed to be January 4th, but they're sticking with the original deadline, which is supposed to be this month, the month of November. And they are fucking people left and right. Kim Tortilla Ass Hines, Tim Pool, and Steven Crowder are all you need to. Well, and that's the thing about Tim Pool. Tim Pool, before he woke up, he was a little bit left leaning, and then when he really saw what the fuck was going on, he jumped ship, man. We need you and Synthol Mark to have a sit down. Yes, fuck dog, we do. Synthol Mark and I would end up becoming two tectonic plates colliding with each other, and the world will never be the same. Absolutely. You know, it amazes me super dank Tim Pool, that snaggle tooth beta. Yeah, nobody's perfect. We're gonna see what happens though after Thanksgiving, because like I'm still waiting to see, are the airlines, are we still getting rid of almost half of our TSA? Augustus. A Synthol Mark and Cuban podcast would be fire. It probably could. I know Synthol Mark and I, we would get into the whole, as Alex Jones would say, we would get into the whole, we're gonna get into the whole zeitgeist in this. And don't forget to buy our products. Go to our website. Get our colloidal silver, get our vital fusion, our supplements, our clothing line. Without your support, this wouldn't exist. Fuck dog 66, the court system is crazy now. You can damn near kill someone and they'll let you out. Well, yeah, if you're living in New York or California right now, cities like, you know, city of New York, city of San Francisco, L.A. Yeah, absolutely. Kim Tortilla asks Hines, if you can schedule Mark in that 45-minute window per day where he isn't masturbating furiously. Yeah. Oh, shit. Oh. Now, Kim Tortilla asks Hines, the only question is now, does he use a lubricant? And if he does use lubricant, what lubricant does he use? Does he use men's Vaseline? Does he use, what's another one called? I don't know. Fucking Oil Valet? Whatever the fuck. Fuck, dog. See, Mark is in chastity right now. Is that her name? Yeah, it's crazy. I've got family members. I guarantee you. It's just a cold hard fact. I've got family members that I guarantee you they think that Joe Biden is doing a great job. Well, actually, no, they don't think that, but they will tell you that just to aggravate the fuck out of you. They know he's doing a piss poor shitty job, and they'll tell you he's doing a great job just to piss you off. That's how evil some of these motherfuckers are, these left-leaning motherfuckers. Chastity sounds like a blonde stripper name. Yes, it does. Fuck Doxy says, Jay hit the nail on the head about Mark. I believe every word he said, and I believe he masturbates 12 times a day.
You guys wanted it. You got it. Nicholas, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me?
I can hear you loud and clear, fans. Here you go.
Hey.
You wanted it. You what? Got it. You've got the Cuban live with Nicholas, and the world will never be the same.
Nope.
Nicholas, what are you doing? Are you walking right now?
Yeah, I'm just getting home. I was walking.
Well, we do want you to get home safely.
Well, I'm home now.
Thank God.
Yeah.
So what did you do today, Nicholas? Did you work today? Did you hang out? What did you do today?
Well, I went to work and then I came home and took a walk. I got off at 3. I've been walking all day.
So you're doing a lot of cardio today?
What?
So you're doing a lot of cardio today?
Yeah, I need to lose the weight.
Well, Father always says you lose weight with the knife and fork.
Right.
Even though you should do cardio. You should do at least I believe it's 150 minutes of cardio a week, which add up to about, you know, a half hour, 5 days.
True.
Nicholas, you're looking good, man. You're looking good. Look at you. Oh, he's got the Charger gear on.
Yep. And then these are my pants. It's hot as hell out there.
Where are you at? Where's your current location right now, Nicholas?
Richmond, Missouri.
Virginia?
No, Missouri.
Richmond, Missouri?
Yeah.
I used to work with a guy that was from Missouri. He never pronounced it Missouri. He always called it Missouri.
Missouri. No, it's not. It's Missouri. And then people from Illinois, they say Illinois, but it's not Illinois. It's Illinois.
That's right.
They call it Missouri. So Nicholas, what?
So, Nicholas, what kind of plans you got tonight? You're going to chill out? You're going to watch some television? You're going to watch a movie? What are you doing?
Yeah, tonight. I'm waiting tonight because Chucky is coming on.
Oh, is it that the series?
Yes.
The new series?
It's the new series.
So are you a fan of Chucky? Are you a fan of horror?
Yes, I love horror.
What are your favorite horror movies?
Well, this year I did watch Halloween. The new Halloween with Jamie Lee Curtis, and then I watched Candyman, but I better not say his name 5 times or her come in the mirror.
Yeah, that's that and the Bloody Mary and all that, that's not suggested. Absolutely not.
Oh. I've been worried about Jay.
Well, Jay would actually love to hear that you're actually worried about him.
Yeah.
But Jay is well. He's well.
That's
good. He's no longer on social media. And he's living the life, Nicholas. He's traveling around the country. He's essentially like dry camping.
What's dry camping?
It's basically just like camping, and I mean, you have to put it in terms of he's traveling around the country. He's usually sleeping in a truck.
Yeah.
So in that truck, he's going to have, you know, bottles of water. He's going to have things to snack on, things that are dry and wet. You know.
Remember Grandma Reba, right?
Yeah.
My her husband passed away in 2018, and when I was little, my grandpa used to take me trucking. And when I was real, real little, my teacher asked me, she goes, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" And I always said I wanted to be a truck driver, but now I don't. I want to be an actor.
And you can be an actor who's a truck driver. There you go. You can play a truck driver on television.
Right.
Oh, my God.
But I don't want to act right now. I want to do it in the future.
That's it. Take your time.
Yeah.
You're not right now.
I want to go to Hollywood. Well, not real. I don't. I want to go. Basically, I don't want to go to Hollywood. I want to go to Universal Studios, but down in Florida, California, Universal Studios, California.
Now, as far as Nicholas, as far as acting, I mean, what is it that you're interested in? Are you interested in theater? Are you interested in television, movies?
Well, I'm not a very good singer. I want to be an actor on television. I kind of, honestly, the truth, I don't want to do it until 2024.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. So you set a date for yourself.
Yes.
And you're doing some cutting right now. You're doing cardio. You're watching what you're eating, and you're taking care of yourself.
Yes.
All right, then.
Yep.
That is awesome.
You know what? What's your name? What's your name?
My name is Gabriel. You can call me Gabriel or Gabe or Cuban, whatever you want.
I'll tell you what. Working, you know, because I work at a grocery store here in town, and, you know, I've worked a lot of places before, and I work at a grocery store, and oh my God, I absolutely just love it. The people that I work with are absolutely super, super nice.
Well, you're blessed, man. That's a huge blessing.
Yeah.
You know, I consider myself blessed too because of not only the company that I work for, but the particular store that I work at, because I work in a grocery store too, and they're my second family. They're great people. They really are.
And I'll tell you what, you know, not to be rude, but, you know, sometimes you work with those damn teenagers, you know, and it's like, it's a nightmare.
Oh, my God. They can't wait to look at their cell phone.
You know,
the latest TikTok video.
Do you watch any soap operas, or did you watch any soap operas, or you wasn't into that kind of stuff?
I will say this: when I was younger,
mm-hmm.
and at that time still living with my mom, like during the summertime, if I was cooped up in the house for whatever reason, the weather, whatever, I was watching soap operas with her. You know, the regular right. stuff. Like General Hospital, One Life to Live,
Days.
I forgot what the other one was. The Young and the Restless.
Well, I'll tell you what. I have a friend. He actually, I'm glad I can share. He's not really a celebrity. But he's not like a celebrity. But he actually played on a soap opera, and his name was Bruce, and he actually played on a soap opera called Passions. Do you remember that one?
I remember that. I never watched it, but I remember that. I remember my first ex-wife. I remember her being into that.
It was, you know what, I tell everybody that looking back on that show, you know, the reason why I watched it, it was because of my good friend, where I live. Yeah, all my children. That was a good one. I can't think what her name was. Was that played on All My Children? Lucy. I can't think what her name is. Do you remember? She was the older lady.
You know, I don't.
Lucy.
It's hard for me to remember characters. I remember that Kelly Ripa, I think she started out on either All My Children or General Hospital.
Yeah. Well, Passions, it was so funny because the guy, not my friend, but they had a little Lucy. No, not Lucy Ball. Lucy, I can't think what her name was. But they had a little guy on there. His name was Josh, and he was a doll, and he was like the main character, and he actually died in like 2018. He was like 25 years old, and he actually died. It was really, really sad. And then when he was alive, he actually was on The Grinch. Yeah. He was his real name was Josh, but his character name was Timmy, and he played on The Grinch. You remember when the Grinch goes, he was really, really mad, and he goes back to like his childhood when he was a kid.
Yes, and he's in the classroom.
Yeah, well, that was actually Josh, but his character name was Timmy on the show. But Timmy was like really, really. Josh was like, I don't want to like defend anybody, but he was like a short person and stuff. But he was really, really funny on the show. And the day he died on the show, his character died the same day. So it was like really, really sad for everybody.
Wow.
Yeah. No, I've been wondering about Jay, you know, I just hope he's okay, you know, and stuff.
Nah, he is well. That's what I'll say. He's well. He's living his life. He's happy. He's actually planning things out, Nicholas, you know, like he wants to, he's not sure yet of what vehicle he's going to purchase, but he wants to purchase a vehicle and convert it, rebuild it into a dragster.
Oh, wow. What, you know, my dad, you know, I shouldn't be mean, but my real dad, he had nothing to do with me growing up, and I lived with him for like a while with my stepmom, and he actually would like, he had Novas, and he had a Chevy Blazer, and he turned it was a 1995 Chevy Blazer, and he turned it into a hot rod, and he used a drag strip, but it was pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, it's those Chevy Blazers are very economical as far as turning them into a dragster, getting an engine for it, everything fitting and everything. It's just, I'm not saying that it's easier, it's just a little bit more economical.
And then my dad had a Chevy Nova too.
So yeah, Chevy Novas were they were nice. Okay. They were really nice.
And then you know what my favorite car was back in the night? Pontiac Transams. I wish they would come back out with Transams. Transams were, when I was a kid, Transams were freaking awesome.
Yes, they were. Absolutely, they were.
Do you remember Knight Rider?
Yeah.
Yeah, a long time ago, I think it was, back in 1996, I went to Disney. I haven't been to Disneyland since 1996. And I remember I was real, real little, and I got to see the Knight Rider's car. And I got to see Fred Flintstone and Harry Henderson. But I didn't get to see Mickey. I was so mad. We went to Disneyland, and I didn't even get to see Mickey. I was so mad. But I did see Goofy.
Hold on, Nick. I need to address something. Nate, 81. What is that? Oh, Nature. Is it Nature YN 81? Anyway, Nicholas did go see his father. Because, Nicholas, I remember you actually went to go see your father recently in the past few months, and you took a picture with him.
Yeah. So
Nicholas has gone to his father. There is no need to discuss any of those things with Nicholas. He went to his father, and he saw his father. So let's move on from that.
But
so, Nicholas...
You know what the best thing about a relationship with a father and mother is? A mother.
What is it?
It's a mother.
The mother?
A mother, they, and no one can never replace a mother. A dad can move on, but a mother is like a best friend.
Well, Nicholas, it really depends on the situation and everything.
Yeah.
I know for myself, in my own experience, the closer you are to either your father or your grandfather, the closer you are to God.
Right.
Now your mom, there's a very good chance if your mom was an absolute saint and a lovely human being, there's a good chance that your mother may have loved her own father and was close to her father.
Well, see, my grandma Reba, she actually had two boyfriends. My mom, my grandpa that was a truck, I had two grandpas. But my mom didn't find out about my grandpa Bob, which he actually is from Germany. There, his last name is Lundenfelser, and he actually is from Germany. And it's really cool because I was talking to like my great aunt, and she said if there's any Lundenfelsers, no matter what, you're related to them. But my mom's dad, she found out that in when she was 44, or I think 40 or something like that, back in 2004, my mom found out that my grandpa Ronnie wasn't really my grandpa, and then Bob, and then 2006, my grandpa Bob passed away, and he didn't have a stroke, but his he kind of had a stroke, I think, but his blood went to his brain.
Oh, an aneurysm.
Yeah. And then my mom has a sister. Her name is Tammy, but I'm glad I can talk about this. But I wish, the biggest thing I wish, like I said, my mom has a sister. Her name is Tammy. But for some reason, my mom's sister, it's her half-sister, she doesn't want anything to do with my mom because she thinks she's out for the money, and my mom's not. She just wants to know her family. And sometimes I pray that my aunt, my mom's half-sister will come around and maybe talk, you know, and stuff.
Yeah, you know, it's family drama. It really does suck. And I've witnessed my fair share of it. And not to get into too much detail, I know that on one specific side of my family, we have family members that don't get along with a particular family member just because of who they're married to.
Yep.
And it kind of sucks because they have kids. And when you treat people a certain way and you don't want them to be part of anything, you're also doing it to the kids.
Yep.
That's the only thing that's the one thing I absolutely disagree with. When it involves kids, it's different, and it just sucks.
Well, talking about kids, I hope one day I get married, but I don't know if I always say, you know that song TLC, No Scrub?
What's that?
You know TLC, No Scrub? I always say that song was based on me.
Nah, you're not a scrub. You're not some dude hanging out the passenger side of his best friend ride trying to holler at a chick.
Right. No, Haley has a boyfriend. His name is Will. Haley can't have kids. I'm hoping, you know, maybe what's going on, maybe I'm looking in the wrong places, you know, but I don't go Jason Waterfalls. Yes, I love that song. Lately I've been hearing that the good guys come in last, and you know, maybe it's not time, or maybe it's not meant to be, but maybe it will. But I hope soon. If I ever get married, you guys can come to my wedding.
Hey, I would love to go to your wedding.
Right?
Father and I will show up.
Definitely.
We'll bring a keg with us.
You know, I have to tell you a story. This is actually true. I kind of believe it now. When I was real little, and I was growing up, people always told me, oh, Nick, if you die, thousands of people are coming up to your funeral. I said, really? They go, oh, Nick, your funeral is going to be huge. I believe it. I believe it now.
I believe it as well. Absolutely. Yep. Absolutely.
They probably would have to be a thousand. There would probably be thousands and thousands of people at my funeral. It might even be on TV.
If like traffic is held up from blocks and blocks and blocks, people just traversing to the graveyard. Oh my God! Going from the funeral to the graveyard. Oh my God!
Yep.
All the traffic and everything. The cops.
You know what? I've always told people this. I said the good people, or the bad people that hurt me, or I forgot how I used to say it. I said, I'm always going to come back and haunt people and flip tricks on them.
So you would be a mischievous. You would be a mischievous ghost.
Yes, I would be a mischief.
You would like take things and move them.
Yep.
Things, yep. Little knocks in the dark.
Yep. You know what's crazy? I love old people. I am fascinated with old people. And sometimes
old people are cute.
What?
Old people are cute.
Yes, they are. And I've my friends that I have told the old people, I if you ever die, please come and haunt me. And they go, Nick, we're going to haunt you. All right.
You got good friends, man. Oh, man.
So what's the plans tonight?
myself, I'm going to go back inside the house, have another beer, and I'm going to watch the first episode of the reboot of Dexter one more time.
Into it. I can't get into it.
It's all right. It's an acquired taste. It's like cigars. It's not for everybody.
Right.
What do you
do for a living?
I work at a grocery store.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry. Are you?
No, I work at a grocery store. I work in the produce department. I get to play with fruit all day.
The produce? Oh, cool.
Yeah, I get to play with fruit all day.
Fruit, Nick, your funeral. Right, my finger is gonna be big. I don't know.
Nicholas, the Weather Channel is gonna talk about your funeral.
Yes, definitely. Definitely.
Even the Weather Channel is gonna talk about your funeral.
Definitely. Could you? I got a question. Could you see me as a movie? As a actor.
And you would need the right role. You need the right role.
The right role. I can't say it. You know what I've always said? I've always wanted to produce like a movie, and basically like I would want to. Oh no! Here we go. Not Will Ferrell. I've always like wanted to like produce a movie and like. Basically, like, die at the beginning. And then, like, people try to figure out if I'm coming back. And then I, like, come back at the end, and they're like, how did he come back? Like, I thought he was dead.
Oh.
Kind of like a mystery movie, kind of. And they would be like, I thought he died, you know. I thought he died, but
well, you can go like as far as like the writing, the audience sees you die, they see you pass away, and then they see you come back. But yeah. What if it's something as simple, it's not really you coming back, it's your twin.
Well, kind of.
You have like a twin that no one knew about. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That could actually become a comedy if you do it right.
Yep. You know what's on tomorrow, don't you? I'm so ready for not to rush the days go by quick, but I'm ready for tomorrow because my show comes on tomorrow and it is I can't think what it is. The Connors with well. Remember Roseanne's not on there anymore because she tweeted about Valerie, whatever her name, that she said she was white. Or no, she was white and blah, blah, blah. But I want to see what happens to Dan tomorrow. Work was good. Do you guys remember Step by Step? Does anybody remember that show?
I do. You know, I do.
You remember Step by Step?
Absolutely, I do.
Well, you know what's crazy about Step by Step is I wrote on YouTube because YouTube has like. People and stuff or like movies and stuff, and I wrote on YouTube about Step by Step that they should do a reunion, and I think they should do a reunion. I think it would be kind of interesting to see, you know, because I want to see Cody. You remember Cody, don't you?
Somewhat, yeah.
Cody, and yeah, I want to see what Cody looks like. And then the one I've been focusing on lately, I want to know if anybody remembers the movie, Problem Child.
Yeah.
I would love to see what Jr. looks like today, I think it would be kind of interesting what he looks like. If he's around, you know, I wonder, he probably doesn't even, I don't even know his real name, but lately I've been going on YouTube and I typed in Problem Child, and I absolutely love the songs, and it's real cool, actually.
What, the song Bad to the Bone?
Yes.
Yeah, that's from George Thorogood and the Destroyers.
But I heard on Problem Child that John Reynolds, or how you say his name? John Reynolds, or can't think.
John Ritter.
Yeah, I heard that he passed away, and I seen on YouTube that he passed away. I was like, what, John died? I couldn't
believe it. Yeah, he died a few years back. You know who his daughter is?
Who?
There is a series on Netflix, and it's a comic book character from the Marvel Universe.
He has a daughter?
I'm sorry?
He has a daughter?
He has a daughter that is an actress on a series on Netflix. I forgot the name of it already.
You don't like John? Somebody said, fuck that. Somebody said they don't like John. I love John. He was funny.
John Ritter on Three's Company was a pimp. He had two female roommates. He was always dating a new chick. The guy was a pimp.
He was. And then remember the guy on the movie on Problem Child. The guy goes, what, you again? And he had that because he played on Aladdin. He was the bird back in Aladdin.
Gilbert Godfrey?
Yes, he cracked me up. And then lately, I've been going back from like 1993. And I've been looking at, like, the clips. You won't believe what I've been watching. Mrs. Doubtfire, The Eclipse.
Mrs. Doubtfire.
Yes. I like the part where he goes, I forgot what that word was. He goes, when he dresses up, he goes, Mom, it's, or he goes, I don't remember. But I like the one, that scene where he goes, he throws the orange at the guy, Stu. One of my favorite parts. And then he goes, huh?
Remember when he gets, he's riding the bus?
Yeah,
and the bus,
his legs are showing.
He's a real woman, and he sits down, and he sees the hairy legs.
Yeah.
He's like, natural, yeah.
I love it. You know what's really, really sad? I wish Robin Williams was alive because, you know, talk about an actor. You know how I was telling? I think it would be cool for me to do Mrs. Doubtfire. But I don't know if I'm the shape of doing Mrs. Doubtfire. But I think, I've been thinking that way. Like, that'd be cool if I could do Mrs. Doubtfire too.
You know, to do Mrs. Doubtfire, you got to understand something about Robin Williams. There were two things that made him brilliant. Number one, he didn't need to write anything. He didn't need a script, and he could just go off the cuff on anything.
Hold on. Only a second. Yike. Only a second. Yike. 911. 911. Oh, police. Oh my God, I'm a woman. I'm getting hot flashes.
Woo!
And then I like the part where Robin, Nick, you, I would be a great Mrs. Doubtfire. It'd be cool. I honest the truth, I would want to work with Sally Field. I don't know what made me think of this, but I would love to work with Sally Field. I think it'd be really interesting. And you know what's crazy? You know, we talk about paparazzi, but I've been thinking lately about like the paparazzi. The people that are like really, really famous, you know, and they got the money,
Oh yeah, I'm here.
Oh, I feel Nick Mary about children. Yes, that's a good one too. I would love to redo that one too, and I would love to be. That's why I want to do Step by Step, because I want to be on Step by Step too. That's the reason why I want them to reboot, because I want, yes, Sally Fields. I love her. But I think it would be interesting. I think it would be fun. I think it'd be a heartbreaker. It would be awesome.
We can get Sally Field to play your grandmother.
Well, that's even better. But she looks, you know what? She looks young. She looks young.
And have you seen any pictures of her lately?
No.
No, she looks like a grandmother, Nick. You gotta trust me on that one.
Really?
She's definitely a gray bear. Yep. You got people calling you up and texting you?
No. You remember Dante's Peak, don't you? That's kind of Dante's Peak.
Dante's Peak, yes.
It was good, but it was kind of a little corny a little bit. It was kind of, I watch it sometimes, but it's kind of a toss up, you know. It's kind of a,
you know, the most streamed television shows on the internet are all old television shows.
Mm-hmm.
There's not really any of the new ones. All of the top streamed shows, they're all old shows.
Ah, rah-rah. You know what I have to say? You know what I've been... You know what Dante's Freak was? No, Dante's Peak. You know what I've been wondering about too, and I can't find the movie anywhere, is I think it was back in 1993, Kirstie Alley came out with a movie. And no, it was not Look Who's Talking. It was called Toothless. Do you guys remember that?
That sounds familiar.
Well, Kirstie Alley, she was a dentist, but then she was crossing the road and she got hit on the show in the movie, and she became the Tooth Fairy, and there was a guy, I can't think what his name was, but no one believed that only certain people could see her and stuff, and she fell in love at the end with this guy. One of the kids' dad. But the most Tootsie, yes, I love that movie. Yes. But the most favorite part was when she had Cupid. When no one, I don't, you know what's funny about Cupid? I don't think people, that's when they say when you're by the first love, Cupid will shoot an arrow, and that's when you know it's first love at first sight, when Cupid shoots.
Hmm. Well, Nicholas, I gotta cut this short, man. I gotta go. I gotta be up at about 5 in the morning.
What time is it for you?
Right now, it is close to 8:30 p.m.
Damn. I got a question to ask you. Can you save this life for me? Jay, I don't know how he did it, but last time I went live, I don't know how the hell he did it, But he saved his life and put it on my YouTube. If you could do that for me, I would really appreciate that. And you could tag yourself in here too.
I will repost this on Instagram and I will post this on YouTube.
You know my YouTube account, right?
No, I honestly, I don't. You have a YouTube account?
Yeah,
you're going to have to send it to me.
I don't know how Jay did it, but I have to show you. Yes, I got a YouTube account. I don't know how he did it, but I have to show you guys real quick. Hold on. Then I have to go. Because the news is coming on, and yes, the news is depressing. Hold on. Very depressing. Hold on.
Call it the bad news.
What?
They should call it the bad news.
Definitely. Definitely. Hold on. Sorry it's taken forever. Hold on. I don't know how to turn it. Oh. Here it is. See, look.
Oh, Diana Maybrook's thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I'll be able to post it. I'll be able to post it on YouTube. It's no problem.
That's Jay. I miss that dude. I don't know how they did it, but I would love this to go on YouTube if you don't mind.
Absolutely.
And I'm
that's not gonna be a problem.
I'm gonna say a prayer. And Caroline, I need to talk to you because I had the weirdest, absolutely craziest dream about you, and no, it wasn't not be a, and not it was not sex, but I'm gonna say a prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we ask you through the grace of God that you bless this people, you bless this around us, and we pray for our Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right.
Amen. Return to the Father.
All right. Bye.